Between Antwerp and the sea was the Scheldt estuary. And along this 50-mile channel, six German divisions had orders to fight to the death. Canadian correspondents began their record of a fierce and filthy battle. On October 6th, the struggle for the Scheldt would begin. The first vital phase fell to the Canadian 3rd Division. They must clear the south bank, the Breskin's pocket. The first attack would be launched across the Leopold Canal. Flamethrowers helped beat back the enemy, and the Canadians jumped the canal. With this pressure in the south, a second prong struck down from the north. After 7 waterlogged days in the stinking swampland, General Dan Spry's 3rd Division had destroyed the German forces on the south bank of the Scheldt. To clear the north bank, the 4th Canadian Division would fight to Bergen op Zoom, while the 2nd Division struck out towards the sea. This was the fetid polder country. Earth reclaimed from the sea. In the muck of this drowned land, a man was never dry. They moved gingerly. The German had stuffed the soggy earth with mines. Death could come from below or above.
Back in France, we got a buck and a half a day. But they'd given us a raise. Now we made $1.70. Like we said, why join up if you can't take a joke?
South Beaveland, at a price, had been won. One last enemy stronghold stood between Antwerp and the sea. Walcheren lay behind a great dike. If that dike was breached, it would flood. Thank you. The sea rolled in. The Dutch adapted to their tragedy with courage. Freedom might soon follow. Germans drove the cattle to the higher land. They must have food for the siege, and so must the Dutch. Walcheren was to be attacked on three sides. The British would strike from the sea and across the Scheldt. During these amphibious assaults, the Canadians and British would storm the narrow causeway and maintain pressure from the east. Commandos crossing the Scheldt were covered by Canadian artillery.
Fire!
The landings at Flushing were not difficult. But the force coming into West Capelle from the sea had a furious fight. Beachheads were secured. A foothold had been seized across the causeway, and the end was in sight. For a month, the Canadians had fought and ate and slept in water. Even under fire, they would often stay in the open and take their chances. If a man was wounded in a foxhole, he could drown. "We will never surrender," the Germans had said. 41,000 Germans were prisoner, and the Battle of the Scheldt was over. It had lasted a month and 2 days. 6,000 Canadians were dead or wounded. The estuary was clear. The Dutchmen who lived in this strange sea land were helped to begin their life again. On November 28th, the first convoy arrived. Allied supplies could now move up from the sea to Antwerp. It was a ceremonial occasion, and somebody had forgotten to invite the Canadians to the party. But a great port was opened,